Real Happiness, The Power of Meditation, by Sharon Salzberg. Read for you by the author. Introduction. Ben started meditating when he was an Army reservist on active duty in Iraq. I became his teacher via email. He told me that he felt meditation would help him deal with the stress and trauma that he faced every day and stay true to his deepest values. Sarah wanted to be a good stepmother. She thought learning to meditate would help her listen more patiently and better negotiate the complex relationships in her newly blended family. Diane took a meditation class I taught at the large media company where she's a division manager. She was seeking more balance between her work life and her home life, she said, and a way to communicate with colleagues clearly and calmly, no matter how crazy things got at the office. Jerry is a firefighter dealing with the aftermath of being a first responder at the World Trade Center on 9/11. Elena needed to concentrate on studying for her real estate licensing exam. Rosie hoped to cope better with chronic back pain. Lisa, the owner of a small catering company, told me that she wanted to stop feeling as if she was sleepwalking most of the time. I'm on automatic pilot, disconnected from myself, she said. I'm so worried about the things on my to-do list or about the future that I'm totally missing my present. I feel as if I'm living my life behind my own back. I've changed the names of some of my students and some identifying details, but their motivations are real, and so are the many ways that the practice of meditation has improved their lives. For 36 years, I've taught meditation to thousands of people at the Insight Meditation Society Retreat Center in Barre, Massachusetts, which I co-founded in 1975, and at schools, corporations, government agencies, and community centers all over the world. I've introduced the techniques you're about to encounter to groups of Silicon Valley entrepreneurs, school teachers, police officers, athletes, teenagers, army chaplains and medics, doctors, nurses, burn patients, prisoners, frontline workers in domestic violence shelters, new moms and dads. My students come from every walk of life, ethnic background, and belief tradition. And they're part of a national trend. A 2007 survey